Hi YouTube family, my name is Vicky and in today's video we are going to learn how we can configure multiple user or multiple user profile with the help of the AWSCLI. First we need to understand why this is important to configure multiple profile on the single machine. Let's suppose you are working for multiple clients where you have the multiple AWS account, and on all the AWS account you have different level of access. Now it is not feasible for you to go with the AWS configure command and every time update the credential for your user, and it is also not recommended way, right? You're not going to ask your DevOps admin or you're not going to ask your AWS admin to create a credential for you, right? They are not going to do that. They are going to provide you with a credential and you need to use that credentials. Till the time they are not going to rotate that credentials. We need to know how we can configure multiple user on a single machine. For this demo, what I'm going to do is I already have one of the Linux machine created and this machine is in the running state. So let me grab the public IP and let me log into this machine. Now if you are not sure how to create a Linux machine, I already have video on that. I will provide you the link in the description. You can go and watch that video so that you can understand how to launch a Linux machine. Okay, first I need to go to that location where I have my key pair. So my key pair is in the download folder. We are good. We logged in to our machine. Now what we need to do is we need to create couple of IAM user. Okay, for that let me go to the IAM. Here I'm going to create couple of user. You can imagine you have couple of AWS account. As of now, I don't have couple of AWS accounts, so I'm not using the AWS account. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to create multiple users with multiple access. So the first user which I'm going to create is S3 access. Okay. And let me go with the access key, next permission, attach existing policy. And for this user, what I'm going to do is I'm going to provide S3 full permission. Now here we have the access key and the secret key. So let me copy the access key and let me go back to my terminal and let me configure my user. And the command to configure my user, that is AWS configure. After that, what we need to do is we need to provide the profile option and whatever the profile name we need to give. So let me give S3 access. Okay. Here we need to provide the access key. Now it is asking me for the secret key and let me grab the secret key from here. Default region name is US East 1 and default or output format is, I'm going to leave this thing default, that is going to be the JSON. Now let me configure one more user here, and this user with the name EC2 access. Attach existing policy, and for this user I'm going to provide EC2 full access. Let me copy the access key. Same command we need to go with AWS configure profile. Here I'm going to provide EC2 access. Okay, now we need to provide the secret key. Let me copy that thing. Default region name is going to be US East 1. Format is going to be the default one, that is the JSON. Now I have configured two user profile on this machine. The first one is with the S3 access and the other one is with the EC2 access. So let's run the command aws-s3ls. This is the command I'm going to run in order to get the detail of all the buckets which I have in my AWS account. Let me hit enter. Now I'm getting a access key because the AWS access key provided does not exist in our record. That's okay, invalid access key ID. Now I know I have created this user with one of the profiles. So let me go with the profile option, profile EC access. This is the name I gave to my profile. Now this user only has access to the EC2, not to S3. Let me check that thing. Access denied. I'm getting access denied. That means this user has no access to the S3. Now let me check with the other S3 access user. I'm able to get all the packet information. The same thing, let me try to get some information related to the EC2. So for that, what I'm going to do is I will go to the official website, AWSCLI. CLI reference, and let's suppose I need to get something related to the EC2. So let me search for the EC2 here. Here we have the EC2. And let's go with the describe instance. Here we have describe instance. Here it is. Let me scroll down and go to the example. Here we have the example. Let me copy this thing. Let me paste it here. Okay, I'm not able to run this thing like this. Yes, now it is fine. Here I need to provide the instance ID. Let me grab the instance ID from where? From my EC2 console. EC2. Let me copy this thing, paste it here. Now I need to give the profile name. Profile is going to be S3 access. Let's see if it is working or not. Profile spelling is correct. Okay, this thing is not correct. Now we are getting unauthorized operation. You are not authorized to perform this action. Why? Because this profile has no access to the EC2. Now let me try with the profile EC2. I'm able to call. So this is how you can configure multiple profile on your local machine, or the machine on which you are working, or on the machine from where you are doing the API call to the resources which are there in the AWS account. You can configure the multiple profile. Now where exactly you can see all the profiles on your machine? So for that, what you need to do is you need to go to the home folder. So I'm already in my home folder with this. This is the tilt sign, and here you need to go to the AWS folder. This is a hidden folder because it is started with dot, and in the Linux, if you have something started with dot, that means it's a hidden one. Let me show it to you. ls, if you do the ls, you will not see that thing. So ls minus lah, if you do, you will see one of the hidden folder, that is AWS. So you need to go to this AWS. Once you go inside this, you will get two files here. One is config and the other one is the credentials. So let me go to the config. Now here, if you see, you have these profile configure. And if you want to see the credentials, you can go to the credentials as well, get credentials, and you will get the credentials as well. So this is for the default profile. This is for the X3 access profile, and this is for the EC access thing, right? We have couple of other commands, other useful commands as well. So let's suppose list profile. Now here you will see all the profile which are configured on your local machine. AWS configure my list profiles. Now if you want to update the region for any of the profile, you can also do that. Let's suppose AWS configure set region is equal to US East 2, minus minus profile s3xs. You can do that. Profile s3xs access. Okay, let me check. s3access. Everything seems to be correct. Okay, I think we it is going to be minus minus profile. We are done. Now if we want to verify it, we can verify it in the config. So let me go and cat config. So if you see, the region is US East 2, right? For S3, earlier it was US East 1, now it is US East 2. By this way, you can update the credentials as well. You can update the profile name as well. So if you want to update the profile name, you can also do that with this command. Now if you need to get the configuration detail, like the access key, the secret key, or the region, you can do that. AWS configure get is the command to get the region, access key ID, or secret key ID. You can do that. Profile S3 access, you will get it. Okay, and this is the export command which you can use. This is very useful. Let's suppose you are working on this terminal, and on this terminal you want to continue with the same profile. You can do that with the export command. So what you can do is, you can export AWS profile, then you need to provide the username here. So let's suppose, let me give s3xs. Now what will happen, whatever the command I'm going to run, that will run with the s3xs profile only. So aws s3ls. Now here I don't need to provide the profile name. What will happen, this is going to be the default profile. Now if I'm not going to provide any profile name, s3xs is the default profile because I have used this export. But one more thing which you need to remember, if you close this thing, open it one more time, what will happen, this terminal will clear and this export command is not going to work. Okay, so you need to make sure that you don't have to close your terminal if you are using the export command. Very useful when you have to, you know, work with a single profile for, you know, a couple of command. That is very useful. Now this is one of the command which is very useful, sgs get caller identity. Here you will get the account name as well, or the account ID as well. So see, you are getting the s3xs right now. Let me go profile. Let's suppose you have multiple profile configured for the multiple AWS account and you want to see the account ID. With this sgs command you will get that information. So let's suppose ecxs. Now here you will get the account ID, the user ID, and this ARN. Very useful command. Okay, and let me close this terminal. Let me open it. See, this time AWS sgs get caller identity. Earlier I was getting the s3xs. Why I was getting the s3xs? Because of this thing, export command, right? But this time I'm not getting anything. I'm sorry for that. That's okay, let me come out of this. Okay, into Python or something. Okay, yes, now I'm out. So let me show it to you one more time. If I go with this export command, profile is s3xs, Okay, now let me go with the STS caller identity. If I'm not going to any of the profile, what will happen? It is going to take the default profile. Okay, now the default profile is S3 access. Now let me close this terminal. Let me log in it one more time. Let me go with this STS caller identity. This time I'm getting error occur. There is no default profile for this. Earlier the default profile was this S3 access because of this export command. So this export command is very useful when you have to run multiple command with a single profile. You can go and do or use the export command, so you don't have to provide the profile name again and again. So in this video you have learned how to configure multiple user, how to work with the multiple profile, how to get information related to the profile, how to update information related to the profile. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, do subscribe my channel. If you are new to my channel, share with your friends, hit the like button. Thank you.